Welcome to another Digital Photo Mentor tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to resize and save your images in Luminar 4. I've already prepared this image and I've completed the processing in Luminar 4. Now all I want to do is crop it to a particular proportion or aspect ratio and save it or export it. So how you get to the crop tool in Luminar is go up here on the right and you'll see there's something that looks like a stack of papers, and then right below it there's a pencil and a ruler, a little icon. And if you hover over it, it says canvas. So select that by clicking it, and then you'll see that the crop and rotate tool is located inside of there. So in order to change the aspect ratio or the proportions of your picture, this is where you're going to go. Now by default, this little lock is usually closed, which means that if I change the cropping, it keeps the proportions. Like I can't change how the height and the width are relative to each other, okay, because it's locked. Okay, let's click the lock to open it, and now you can have free reign of how you want to crop your image, including free. So free means that you can make any type of proportions you want by dragging in on the left, right, top, or bottom in any orientation you want. But let's say I want to make this my Facebook cover, right? Well, there's a handy set of presets inside of Luminar, one of which is Facebook cover. And the Facebook cover itself is a very long and narrow format, and not very many images, or not a lot of images, are suitable or going to work in that shape. So you could see that this one works really well. So once you choose that proportion, I can drag the image up and down inside of those dimensions, or even come in closer, crop in closer by grabbing the handles, right? So if I want to do 16:9 or another common ratio, those are all here for you to choose from as well. Choosing 16:9, grab the handles, and then I can just adjust it inside of those parameters, right? So for this demonstration, I'm going to go ahead and do the Facebook cover. So I'm going to choose those proportions, align it, and then just click done. So now I've got the cropping aspect ratio as I want it to be. Now I need to export it in the right size. To get to the export in Luminar, there's a little square with an up arrow on the top bar right up here. So just click it and you'll see that you have the option of exporting to image. That's what we're going to do here. Now you have this dialog box that opens up, and I'm going to choose the folder to save it in. And then I'm going to decide, okay, what size do I want to save my image? So this is where you get to choose the pixel size in terms of length and width, or the long side, and how much you want to reduce the quality or crunch the image to reduce the file size or the space that it's taking up on your hard drive, right? So first thing you'll see here down the bottom under this dialog box is an option to resize. So if you have it set to original, it doesn't give you the option of changing the size. You can see that my original is 4,440 by 1,689, and I can't change it because I'm going to export based on the original size. That's what you want to avoid doing if you're sharing your images online. So you want to resize it so that it's going to give you a smaller size, which loads faster online and is less likely for people to steal your image or that type of thing. So the first thing we're going to do is change the resize pull-down menu to long edge. Right. So long edge, what that means is that if you have a landscape or horizontal image, whatever number you type in here, the longest side is going to max out at that size. Okay. Now I know that, for example, the Facebook cover image is 820 by 312 pixels. Okay. So let's just type in 820 in here. Okay. And it should automatically resize it to the correct size for the Facebook cover image, because it will automatically set the width, set the height, pardon me, according to the ratio that we've chosen. Okay. Then the next thing you get to choose is your format. For most things online, and in most images in general, you're going to want to choose a JPEG. Very rarely are you going to want to use any of these other formats. PNG would be something that you would use if you have a transparency as part of your image, or if you want to save it as a PDF that you can have sort of a more universal document. But for most images, it's going to be a JPEG, right? And you can decide if you want to add a little bit of sharpening or not when you're exporting. Okay. Now the last piece I'm going to do is I always add a little suffix or something at the end of my file that lets me know what size it is. And I'm just going to call it Facebook cover. So that if I'm exporting multiple versions of this image, which I'll do in a second one, I'm not going to get them confused and grab the wrong one later and use it for the incorrect purpose. Once you're happy with your settings, just go ahead and click save and Luminar will export the image. You'll see that it saves and then I can check the image. So here is the exported image on the hard drive and you can see that it is the right proportions. It is saved at 820 by 311, 311, 312, okay, close enough, and that's going to crop well and save well as my Facebook cover. Let's try one more. All right, so if I don't want this cropping, I can just go back in my history and undo the crop and do it again. So let's go back to crop. And this time I'm going to leave it at 16 by 9 because I kind of like the little bit of sky cropped off, but not quite so much as the fully panoramic Facebook crop. And this time I'm going to export it to send by email. Okay, now there's a couple of things that you need to know about this. Currently in Luminar 4, there is a mail preset. Okay, there is a bug that is a known bug with this one that if you use that setting, it will create an image that is full size and it is very large. Okay, so don't use that one. Go back to the export to image and then just change the long side to 800. And change the quality to about 70. Okay, so this is a percentage of image quality. It's going to downsize the file quite a bit. So make it more user-friendly for sending by email so that you don't have send this to your friend or send a bunch of images to your friend and totally clog up their inbox. Okay, so let's export this one at 70%. Make sure that your color space is sRGB as well. So whenever you're doing anything for online usage, make sure that you're using this sRGB color space. I'm not going to get into the color spaces too much in this video because it's beyond the scope of what I can explain here in a couple of minutes, but just know that as you go down the scale, you have more and more colors. So sRGB is the smallest color space and the least amount of colors, and Profoto is the largest, but not all purposes need that. You don't need Profoto for most things and not everything can handle it. Okay, so your safe one is sRGB. If you know for sure that you're making an image to print and your lab can handle Adobe RGB, then use that one, but double check with them before you send them an Adobe RGB file. Again, default to sRGB as the safe one. So this time I'm going to apply a little bit of sharpening, make sure that it's 800, and I'm going to go ahead and export it. So here's the second exported image. You can see that it is 800 by 449, so it's got a taller pixel height than the other image, and it is 70 kilobytes in size. You'll also notice that I changed the file name to have a little suffix or extension dash email. So I know that this is a small file that I can grab to send to somebody by email. And the Facebook cover one you'll see is considerably larger because we didn't crunch it. Okay, so look at the difference in terms of file or storage amount space on the hard drive. The one that I didn't crunch is marginally bigger pixel size, but 294 kilobytes. Versus this one, which is 70. Okay, so it's about four times as large. Let's do one more just to show you what it looks like if we do a full export and you can see the size difference. So back in Luminar, we're going to export and we're going to change it back to original size. We're not going to crunch it And I'm not going to do any sharpening. And I'm going to put the image in here. And remember, I'm going to edit this so it says full size. And that I've created it in Luminar. Right? It may take a moment longer for Luminar to export this one because it's a bigger file that it's creating. And then once it's done, we will take a look at the finished file as compared to the others. Okay, so here is the full size version, and you can see that the pixel size is the same size that we had inside of Luminar, and now the file size is 9.6 megabytes. Okay, so can you see the difference if I wanted to email that to somebody, or let's say I wanted to send them a dozen images or more? Okay, this is quickly going to add up to many, many megabytes. You might end up with 50, 80, 100 megabytes. That's not something that you want to send by email because you're going to cause a server crash, or your email might actually not get to its recipient because their server might say, sorry, that's too big, we can't even send it. Okay, so that's why you always want to downsize your images, particularly for email, and use small ones because they can't be displayed really large inside of an email anyways. And if you want to send large files to your friend or to share with somebody, use Google Drive or Dropbox or something to send them the full size version. Okay, I lied. I'm going to do one more example for you. One that's very common, and that is just a Facebook share. Okay, so if you're sharing for Facebook, you can make it any proportion you want. So I'm not going to recrop the image, but I am going to re-export it. So back to that dialog box one more time. And the ideal export size for Facebook, you want to resize on the long size again, it's an odd size, and you may hear different or differing opinions on what size is optimal. This is the one that I found works the best for me, and I get the best image quality on Facebook. Facebook tends to crunch images when you upload them, so if you pre-crunch them and change this quality, or you start with a smaller pixel size image, the ones that you share on Facebook may end up looking unsharp or pixelated. So I'm going to change my file name, and I'm going to call this Facebook 2048. Right, so that is the actual file size on pixels. I'm going to save it as the long edge. I'm not going to apply any sharpening, and I'm going to leave it at quality 100. Okay, so that is the settings. Those are the settings that I find get me the best results when saving to Facebook. So we'll go ahead and export the image. So here's the image, and you can see the one that I saved the file name. It's 2048 by 1151 pixels. So remember, it sets the height automatically to keep the proportions, and the file size is 1.9 megabytes. Now, the nice thing about this is I find that this size works the best on Facebook because Facebook crunches them already. It has an algorithm of its own that downsizes your images. So starting with a little bit higher quality and a little bit larger image, I find gets me the best results. Give that a try and play with the sizing and see what works for you. I also find that if you are wanting to share in the comment area of our website, Digital Photo Mentor, or on any other website that uses the discuss system, you need to make sure that your images are 2 megabytes or less. And you'll notice that this one here that I saved in the Facebook size is in that size range as well in terms of 2 megabytes. So use that size for Facebook and for discuss comments, and for most of the time, you're going to be safe. Right. If you find that it's still a little bit too big over the 2 megabytes, go back and export it again and maybe crunch it a little bit or change the pixel size a little bit smaller. But just make sure that if you're sharing it in a comment on the website that it's under 2 megabytes as a JPEG. Those are the specs that you need to make particular note of. So I hope that gave you some good ideas in terms of how to size your images correctly for different usages, social media, email, and for print, and that you can make better use of the crop tool and the export function in Luminar 4. Until next time, take care.